I'm going to demonstrate the vegetation structure method using the cover pole. The vegetation structure method provides information on visual obstruction and habitat structure and thus suitability for various wildlife species. There are a number of different visual obstruction methods that are in circulation right now and reported in the literature, including the Robel pole, the modified Robel pole, and various cover boards. This method can be easily illustrated by me standing here behind this shrub in front of me. I am partially obscured by the shrub, and this is what the method is designed to illustrate. Instead of using me, however, which is a pretty non-standard board, we're going to use this cover pole, which is 1.5 meters in height. This is the standard cover pole for the method used by the NRCS NRI. This pole at the bottom has bands that are 2 inches in width, and at the top, the bands are 4 inches in width. From a distance of 4 meters down the line towards the zero end, we are going to observe each of these bands and record whether or not they are obscured. We define obscured as for the smaller bands as being 50% covered, and for the larger bands as being just 25% covered. So the first thing we need to do is measure a distance back from this pole of 4 meters, or 13.4 feet. We're then going to move out 1 meter from that point to the north side of the line and make our observations from that location from a height of 1 meter, or about 39 inches.
I'm standing here at the 13.4 foot mark on the tape, or the 4 meter mark on the tape. We've pulled the tape tight, making that measurement. I set this pole down that is a meter long, perpendicular to the line, stand it back up, and this is the location then that I'm ready to make the observations on the cover pole. Remember that the bottom half of the cover pole, the bands, I'm looking at obstruction being 50% of those bottom bands, and on the upper half of the pole I'm looking for obstruction at 25% of those bands. Jeff is holding the pole, and he will be recording as I read the information out. I'll go ahead and read each one of the bands as I look up. I focus my eye on the top of this pole and look at the cover pole that Jeff is holding, and I can't even see band number one. So it's covered. So Jeff is marking band one, band two, band three I can see more than half of, band four is covered, five is covered, six is covered, seven I can see more than half of seven, so it's Jeff doesn't mark it on the record sheet. 8 is covered, 9 is covered, 10 is covered, 11 and 12 are covered. Band 13 now is the bigger band, so I'm looking at 25% coverage instead of 50%, and band 13 is covered. 14 is not, and none of the bands above that have any obstruction, so 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21 have no obstruction. One of the other aspects of this method is to record the top height of all the vegetation that's within a 6-inch circle of the cover pole. You can see that Jeff is now measuring the cylinder 6 inches around that pole, and he measures the top height of the vegetation to be 2.1 feet. That's done at every point using that pole. And the person that is holding the pole and doing the recording takes that measurement and records it.